Welcome back to Let's Play Mad Max. I'm BurningDogFace. And the magnum opus is fueled up. So we're heading off to the graveyard to find ourselves a body to put on this thing. Kind of reminds me of that car from Half-Life 2 right now. Oh, shit. I really like how responsive the audio is to whether you're pressing the gas down or not. Ooh. Oh, don't want to run into that. That's
nobody
a whale.
Around. Their gate unguarded. Gasoline, Saint. Huh? One blast should split it wide open.
So let's make this one count.
Nope, can't search for that guy either. I got that, yeah. Don't worry about it. Can't run to this. Ramming restricted, eh? Knock, knock!
Exaltation! She's cracked open!
We should not be sitting above that fire.
Wardens of this place, murder on sight!
Oh, yeah, okay, let's do that then. Graveyard, a place of cultural significance for the buzzards. It seems that they keep car bodies here before transforming them into war machines. Apparently they do not dare bring these car bodies down into their tunnels before their transformation. The buzzards are very superstitious, and believe that such car bodies might have a negative influence on some metaphysical plane before they have been cleansed by spiky transformation. It is also from this place that many buzzards launch their nightly hunts across the wasteland. This place is barred up and heavily booby-trapped. Only when the buzzards are out on their hunts can someone enter, but at huge peril. Thanks for mentioning all that in advance, Chumbucket. I mean, I guess stealing from lunatics kind of comes with the territory, but you know.
The fiends that tend this kind of cult don't like strangers. Dangling man killers everywhere! Tread careful!
Great. That was close. That would explain that. I was wondering how dangerous that would be if you had a proper car body. Turns out it's a bomb.
More traps ahead.
Careful, weave between these objects. Three scrap, noted. Seems surprisingly little for such a spacious place, but whatever. I thought that was a person at first, that thing right in front of me. I wonder if that just happened to fall, if we hit a wire, or if someone just really, really missed their timing. Can I just say, by the way, I am really impressed that, in this wasteland, you've still got two working headlights. Oh, I see those are floodlights strapped to the frame. Okay. Running. I think I actually took damage from that.
There! prize ripe for the taking. Go quickly.
That?
The only way to get up there is through those cave tunnels.
Doesn't look any different from the ones outside.
Get the car in place down here. I'll lower the body onto it.
Yes. She'll be ready. As I will. Oh, you'll be as grand on the outside as you are on the inside, my love.
Obviously out of his goddamn mind. But hey, at least he's helpful. I'm going to assume we fixed the dog at some point. Yeah, I noticed that. Oh, that's creepy.
Maybe I could zip down this.
What? Oh, that. I'm kind of surprised it didn't wear through that ancient shotgun.
Flashlight.
What? I didn't dare dream there'd be a flashlight in this game. Missed. Flashlight. Not being able to see your enemy is a great disadvantage at night or inside poorly lit tunnels. The flashlight remedies this.
Still works too.
Better, that's certainly true. I wrote that down somewhere. So, obviously, Mad Max was made famous by Mel Gibson, and then he was played by Tom Hardy in Fury Road. But in this game, Max Rockatansky is voiced by Bren Foster, who is probably best known for his role in the TV show, which ended a couple years ago, The Last Ship, in which he played an Australian Special Forces soldier named Wolf Taylor. And I bring this up because I thought this was interesting. I only recently learned, actually, that Mel Gibson wasn't Australian, to my chagrin. Oh, hell yes. But yeah, it turns out, he wasn't Australian, he was American, and he moved to Australia as a child, and lived there long enough to have the accent by the time he did the first Mad Max movie in 1979. Oh, okay.
Choose! We get down here so we can escape with our skins!
Let me just grab this thing first in case there's a cutscene after that. They all tied to the same one? Yes? Okay. You know what? I bet if I do this, it'll give me a better view. Okay. Furnace. Shovel face. Wild hunt. Death rattle. Die roller. Okay, right off the bat, I'm not in love with Shovel Face or Wild Hunt. Actually, no, that was, I was thinking the other one. The furnace is okay. I'm gonna say no to that one. It's not bad, not bad. I like the shape of it, but, up front, it's kind of a mess. I think I'm gonna go with Die Roller. Oh, I see. And this is the actual bodies. I am really glad that they have these images, though, because, it looks much better from this angle, doesn't it? Yeah! Yes, I do. So why do I bring up Brandon Foster? Fuck. Raza Rattler, I slash, I stick, I feed your insides to the sand. The most skilled and fearsome sand rattlers are given sharp blades to increase their deadliness in combat. These are some of the fiercest fighters you can encounter in the wasteland. Raza Rattlers are deadly with their sharp blades, and well-timed evasion is crucial to avoiding their flurry attacks. Yes, I can grab the knife! The shiv is a deadly weapon. Ow. Oh, it's doing that again. Oh. He's dead! Fucking shit out of these guys. Hey, I thought I blocked that. Oh, right, animation. God damn it. We're running. Take the first time. Oh wow, that was fast. Oh god. Oh good, this is happening. Use left bumper and right and B to aim and fire at weak spots with the shotgun. Use X and L to form a side ram to the left or to the right. Get out of my way! I cannot drink my canteen in here. And we're running! Oh, fuck. Those rocks are just painted on. You know, let's just keep going forward. I bring up Brandon Foster because,
There's creatures of the underworld.
Because, with Mel Gibson being American and Tom Hardy being, British, Brandon Foster is actually the first Australian who has actually played Mad Max. Chumbucket calls it the Magnum Opus. It's not much of a car now, but it has potential. I found a body, but more work is needed before it's battle ready.
Oh, oh, praise be! We're alive and free in the graveyard! Wait, something's loose. I can fix it now if you stop, or later, at my sanctum. It's your choice.
Let's do that now.
Keep the car safe.
Can I do that? Oh no, it's just doing the thing for me. Fine, I needed to do that anyway. Ah, good. Oh, almost used up all of it. Crap. Thank you, Chumbucket. Oh, God. So if I get out now... Yeah, he just does the thing. Okay. Does that mean this hunchbacked friend is going to be with us all the time, or...? Scraped against the wall. Well, yeah, his paw's all wired up, I think. Kinda hard to tell in this light. Haha! Flashlight. Oh, wait a minute. I really like that the light beam falling on this board is shaped like Australia. Just saying. I mean, you can see that there's an Australia-shaped hole just up there. Sorry, a reverse Australia-shaped hole up there. Where is the dog? Where is the doggery-do? Oh fuck, this is Australia. That is absolutely- I was gonna just call the dog, Dog, because, let's face it, nothing good ever happens to dogs in Mad Max. But now I find that I cannot resist the temptation to just call him Doggery-Doo. Oh no. Where is the dog, anyway? It sounds like he's coming from over here. Oh. I watched Mad Max Beyond Thunderdome just last night, and I swear that he never actually says his name. Here you are. Can I pet you? You cannot pet the dog in Mad Max. Well, okay, this is the beginning of the game. Let's keep going.
I need more than just a body and some wheels.
Hey, man! Parts, scarce as they are. Help me gather all this scrap. I'll fashion a harpoon.
What? Amen. Why do we need a harpoon?
With the harpoon sent, we'll gain entry into many sealed places. May also prove to be useful in battle.
How so?
Why, we could use it to defeat enemies, rip off doors, even wheels.
Hmm. I guess that answers that question. March forward, says my lozenge wrapper. Good. Scrap is important.
So, we got all we need?
Just junk and parts.
Yeah, but the jag tip, it's not here. See? It's not here at all. Yeah, it's in my bunk. For, it's just there for, safe keeping. See?
Wait. No, it's... What? Oh. Noted. Oh, fuck. Oh, God. No, it's not... Nope. Let's not worry about that. Oh, it's that screwdriver he was licking, I think. Oh, no, that is an actual... Where did you get that? I'm gonna be honest, I was kind of expecting like a big
livers, this harpoon will be very useful.
Shrine made of engine parts.
Got the jack tip.
Welcome to the garage. This is where the magnum opus will be constructed and customized. I don't know why I said garage that way. There's the timer. The harpoon category is marked with a mission objective. Go there now to install the base harpoon. So, just for the sake of it, ramming grill, armor, engine, exhaust, tires, suspension, boost, rims, border spikes, hood ornament, decals, body color, car body, repair speed, side burners, thunderpoon. No, not gonna go there. Harpoon and sniper rifle. Why is that a car upgrade? I like that. Okay, fine. No hood ornament. Let's put the harpoon on, then. Max has collected the jag tip and enough scrap to install the base harpoon. Ahoy, with this tool we can rip off enemy doors at elegance and ease. It's also a weak structure, so fall prey to it. Install base harpoon and attach two minor elements like... Oh, geez, I thought that was a picture. That's really funny. I was trying to scroll down. I guess there is no down on that. Install base harpoon and attach to minor elements like vehicle doors and weak structures. It's also very effective on people. 15, geez, I can afford like 10 of these. Base harpoon successfully installed. Max also has enough scrap to install a ramming grill. Wait. Adding a front grille increases overall ramming damage to vehicles and structures. It also provides protection to the front of the vehicle during head-on collisions. Good to know. Tussle bar. To bump and grind with a simple bar is better than doing so buck-nude, but just a tad. I wonder who says that. It's not crazy enough to be a Chumbucket. Increase ramming power by 10%. Reduce head-on collision damage by 10%. That's the preview. Great!
To stand a chance, she'll need nitrous! I know how, but we'll need the parts.
We just get them. It'll be easy with the harpoon.
Yes, but first, Scrotus war boys are out there. And if we don't weaken their numbers, why, it'll mean the end of you, me, and the magnum opus.
All right, let's do it.
Harpoon. Description. After installing the harpoon, Max and Chumbucket can use it to rip off enemy car parts as well as gates and other obstacles. Wait for that to fade away, because there was another thing in there that I hadn't gotten around to yet. I guess I couldn't read it. Shit, was it in here? Shiv! That's what it was. Homemade fighting blades. Very effective, but also brittle. Being so expendable, it's wise to keep a supply of them. Oh, this is everything on this page. Fair enough, we are already halfway there with this. So we've got Scrotus enemies, roadkill enemies, and buzzard enemies. I do like that the fucking cars are listed as characters. Skink. Let the sand drink the blood of my victims. Skinks are the lowest in the buzzard ranks. They are more numerous but less trained, and when not led into combat by a night lizard, they are put on more menial mining tasks and guard duty. They occasionally use subterfuge to hide under the sand, patiently waiting for their prey. Once the victim is close enough, they attack fiercely. A skink can be startling if buried, terrifying even. Once he's out in the open, his fighting style is not very challenging. Barbican. We fly across the sand, we bring death to you. These are fast-rolling rods, always at the front lines in buzzards attack. They hunt smaller prey with abandon, but wisely leaves sturdier victims to the heavy vehicles in the back. Barbacons can be found roaming the wasteland in smaller groups, looking for scavenging opportunities. They are fast but relatively easy to defeat. When battling the Barbacon, it's best to go for weak spots, such as the back part of the vehicle. A shotgun or an upgraded harpoon can be are great weapons in a fight against the Barbacon. There is so much shit to keep track of, you guys. Holy shit. That's confusing. But I will select nothing. No, it doesn't make it go away. Fine. I have no decals. And no body colors. Base rust. The magnum opus. Naked and bare. There's nothing to distract from natural beauty. Sadly, I don't see a green in there. Oh, well.
I, for one, would like to commence the sacred work.
Me too, but I have to do an outro first. I'll see you on the next episode of Let's Play Mad Max, Burning Dog fans. We got work to do. Later.